me Abhishek, and I'm gonna tell you how to make your own game, and own an easy game with a software called Stencyl. Stencyl is a free platform, as it comes for Flash games and everything. But if you opt my this tutorial series, I'm gonna tell you how to create a game, Android game, without buying their subscription. So first I'm gonna tell you how to make just a simple basic game. I'm making this tutorial because as first I made my this game, I struggled a lot. I went from here to there. So I'm gonna tell you to make as simple as possible, just a game like Mario and everything, as easy as possible made for you. So first go to Google and type, if you like it, do not forget to like, hit the like button or subscribe me for whole tutorial series. Just type Stencyl and go to download. I have got Windows version here, so you just go on to Windows. If you want to make Mac or iPod or iPad, anything games, you have to download Mac version because it's not possible in Windows. So just download it. As you can see, I have to cancel it because I have already got it here. And after you download it, it's just a simple procedure of installing. After you install it, it's gonna look something like this. Here you can see Stencyl start and close, blah blah blah. Go to here, as you can see, these are all my projects. Go to click here to add a new game. This is a blank game, and we are starting from scratch. Enter the game. I'm naming it demo 3 because I'm already got demo 1 and demo 2 in my folders. Go to demo 3 and go to backgrounds, create new. Here, click add and name it background. Background is important because it's gonna give you color and everything for your game. And I think I missed out with spelling here. Yeah. Create, add a frame, choose an image. As you can see, I've already got a background made it out of paint. You can see the level of expertise here. Just add background. As you can see, the resolution of the background is also 640 by 480. Just add it. The pretty simple blue color background. You can easily make it out of paint or anything else. Just go to scenes and add this. Enter a name. And name is the most important thing. So I'm gonna name it main one because it's gonna be the first game, first scene of the game. Create. Go to background and add. Click here, add button. As you can see, we have already got background, so it's just shown here. Okay. And then go to behaviors and see. Then save the game, because till you don't save the game, it's not gonna show the background. Then go to stencylworks. Stencylworks is the place where you can get everything for your game. Character, platform, you name it, and they got it for you. Platform, and then hit tile sets. As you can see, go to tile set and add this. I have selected this because this is pretty decent and small sized tile set, and it's got everything. Then go to name. As you can see, you selected it there, and it already shown in here because it's a type of tile. Just we're gonna select place it randomly, just add it randomly. As you can see, I'm not emphasizing here on graphics because I'm gonna make it as short as possible. Just select it and then again go to Stencyl Forge and select Mambo. Mambo is the character here. It's gonna move, jump just like Mario. just enter hit Mario Mambo, hit enter and go to actor types and hit most downloads, because Mambo is kind of a hidden. Go to download, you can see they got lots of character here. Just download it, it's gonna take a while. This software is pretty heavy, and I got Ryzen processor here, but it's already taking time on it. But this software is as best as far as I've seen. So please release it, because I have already got it. I just downloaded to show you people. And then, as you can see, it got all animation and behavior. I'm not gonna emphasize on that. Go to actors and just select member. Hold shift and drop the member wherever you want. I told you to hold shift because it's gonna auto arrange to its best position. Then go to stencylworks again and select coins. Coins is the main part here. Here the main thing starts. Yeah, we got a spinning coin, yippee, just like Mario. The coin will have, yeah, we gotta go to behavior of the coin and add. Behavior means what will coin do when something strike with it. If Mambo slash strike with it, it should disappear. So we will say die on collision and add an event. Go to an animate and click collision, and remember to select actor of type. And then actor of type, we got member here, and okay, here self means coin and hits a member, so it should kill itself. Kill means disappear, the coin should disappear. So here we will kill itself, so kill self. And sound, play this sound when it's kill, just like the Mario coin sound when it's a tin 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 collecting sound. Just play the sound and then go to stencil force again and go for sound. I'm just gonna say it sound here because I don't want any copyrights and anything, just like the flappy bird guy. So I'm just gonna select sounds, and I'm gonna just select random explosion sound. Because if I select Mario sound, I'm gonna get copyright and all, and everything in my video will not be get to upload on YouTube. Just check it. As you can hear it, it's got a nice sound of explosion. Then go to spinning coin and add. Choose up to explosion. Explosion will be shown here as fast as you can. Add it here. Then go to main one and add spinning coins. Before spinning coin, I would suggest you to add these things. These things are the best things. Please place them randomly. As you can see, I'm making this video as soon as possible or as fast as possible, but you can take time and design it the far better way. This is the best software. Then go to spinning coins and add them randomly. Yeah, like this. Anything, hold shift, anything. These coins are gonna rotate and everything. So then go to coins, spinning coin again, and go to physics, and in properties select them as tiles. Do remember guys, select them as tiles. And then go to behaviors again, and just I'm checking everything is right or in its place. And then go to main everything, and go to physics. Gravity is just like the gravity we people surround everywhere. If you select 85, it will be just like the gravity we people experience. But I'm gonna make the character jump higher, so I'm just selecting less gravity, so it's gonna jump freely. If you set gravity 0, it's gonna fly in the air. I'm gonna just click on test scene. So here I'm testing the first game, and it's the best, easy and far, most fastest game made. So you're gonna check its best. it's gonna take a while. So you, I think, actually people just forward where the game test starts. Here's the game, and you, as you can see, the coins falls, and we're gonna change that thing. Just again go to spinning coin, and just no, we don't want coins to be affected by gravity and fall off. Just select no and save the game and test it again. It's gonna take a while again now, so I just prefer you forward to the place where it's gonna take to the testing game. Yeah, so here we are. You know, as you can see, Mambo moves. Got pretty excited. As you can see, Mambo moves. And all the coins. I think it's the problem with the coins, we have to fix it. It's already happened, guys. Edit behavior and we should kill self when this actor kills him. As you can see, we are testing the game again. Compiling. And here's the game. So we got coins here. I got fix it. Yeah, you can see collision voice. You can. It depends on your creativity, guys, how best you can make out of it. It's the best software available out there, so you can add everything. So thank you for watching, guys, and do like it, because I have put an effort for it, put an forward an effort for you, so please.